Ladies and gentlemen, will you please stand and remove your hats for the presentation of the colors by North Dakota 20061 AFJROTC. The national anthem is being sung today by senior vocalist Chance Olson. Please remain standing and hold applause until the color guard has left the area.
Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we watched, were so gallantly streaming. And the rocket's red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled banner yet wave o'er the land of the free and the home of the brave?
Please be seated. Family, friends, teachers, class of 2015, welcome to the graduation ceremony of the 50th class to walk the halls of Fargo North High School. It is my pleasure to introduce myself, Ashley Blazik, Student Council President and Master of Ceremony this afternoon. It has been said that the class you see before you today is known for many things. We are highly academic. We not only have someone who scored perfect on his ACT, but all of us contributed to North High being named the number one high school in North Dakota, as seen in US News, World Report magazine, and publications. Yeah. We are a fun class. No one can dispute that this group is the four-time consecutive winner of the Spirit Stick. At least that was our perspective. Taking back the White House! Yeah. See what I mean? We are technologically savvy. We know how to survive an entire school day on our tablets with only 15% battery life, and successfully hide playing games on our tablets from teachers. So essentially, the class of 2015 would make for excellent tech support if anyone has trouble with a Latitude tablet. We can critically think, we collaborate, we are great communicators, and we are all creative. Yes, teachers, we have learned those 21st century skills that you emphasize daily, and we are ready to begin our journey in becoming successful and productive citizens in this world. We are great at making memories. Homecoming weeks, collecting the most food for Fill the Dome, struggling through the ACT together, and even the time that little girl won the belching contest at the freshman retreat. These are the moments we'll never forget. Now, it is also my pleasure to introduce those present on stage with me. Please hold applause until the end. To my right is Assistant Principal Travis Christensen, Senior Speaker Sarah Tarvested, Assistant Principal Dr. Kathy Cieslak, National Anthem Singer Chance Olson, School Board Member Linda Boyd, Superintendent Dr. Jeffrey Schatz, Principal Andy Dolan, Senior Speaker Beth Podall, School Board Member Robin Nelson, and Assistant Principal Mark Blanchin. We also have with us Jana Gunderson and Stacy Tornell, our American Sign Language interpreters for today's ceremony. Today, we have the pleasure of hearing from two members of the senior class speak on behalf of the 2015 graduates. I'm honored to introduce a dedicated speech and debate team member who was recognized this year with the National Speech and Debate Association Academic All-American Award. In addition to speech and debate, she has conducted scientific research at NDSU and plans to further her research efforts at UND this summer. Please join me in welcoming my fellow classmate, Sarah Tarvested.
Welcome, everyone. The class of 2015 welcomes the family, friends, administration, and staff. Today, we come to reflect upon the years of education that have brought us to the point in time where we can celebrate the past and welcome the future. In the words of Steve Jobs, you cannot connect the dots looking forward. You can only connect them looking backwards. So you have to trust that the dots will somehow connect in your future. You have to trust in something. Your gut, destiny, life, karma, whatever. This year marks the 50th anniversary of Fargo North High School. There have been 49 other graduating classes from Fargo North, but today it is our turn. It is our turn to honor the past and embrace our futures like so many others have before us. The past is our history. It has been the vehicle that has carried us to this moment. I encourage everyone to understand and respect their past. Sure, there are moments, events, people, and issues that may be troubling at best and traumatic at worst. However, we must learn to honor our pasts. Honoring means to recognize that from those times, we have grown into the people that we are. Those times, good or bad, have helped us grow into the people that we are today. Over the years, many things have changed. Our class alone has been through many changes. We started preschool in 2001, when the 9/11 terrorist attacks crumbled the World Trade Center, and when YouTube first went online. In 2005, Disney World celebrated its 50th anniversary, and the infamous Hurricane Katrina struck New Orleans. 2008 brought us change with the election of Barack Obama and with the Beijing Olympics. And in 2012, the world was supposed to end because of the Mayan calendar. But here we are in 2015, alive and well. Today we look back upon our past as we graduate high school. The first day of high school was a huge milestone for parents and students alike. I remember walking up to the school and seeing the giant yellow banner that read, "Freshman Entrance." At first I thought, oh wow, now I'll be an easy target for the upperclassmen. But then I realized that high school is nothing like the movies. Things may seem scary at first, but they truly aren't once you get through them. Moving forward, the high school experience is something that should be honored because of how much we have grown and what we have gained. I've learned many things inside and outside the classroom during my 4 years at North, while making memories that I will never forget, and all the while having the pleasure of going through the regular school diaries that aren't marked by yellow banners. For some, the future is scary. For others, the unknown is a cause for excitement. There's a practicality in looking to the future. Today is the tomorrow that we prepared for yesterday. We students leave high school with our dreams, what we hope for in the future. We began high school as children, but now we're leaving here as adults. We've completed a basic education that will serve as the platform we use to launch ourselves into our futures. Some of us will go on to college, others will go straight into the workforce or military, and still others have no clue. But that's all right. Each of us will travel on our own path. Our individual successes benefit society as a whole, because when we succeed, we are in a position to give rather than to take. What this means as we move forward is, although it may not be easy to see, every accomplishment we achieve is added to the world's accomplishments. What we do will influence and affect the world. Within our graduating class lies tons of potential waiting to be harvested. We have the ability to cure fatal diseases, invent new technologies. The possibilities are endless. When great feats are met, everyone benefits. It is up to us to add our achievements and to make a difference in the world. The future is truly in our hands. So let's make the most of it and embrace it. Let's welcome our futures with open arms, open minds, and open hearts. When I think of our class, I will think about the past we have shared and what our futures all entail. As we walk into the wider world today, let us not forget that we must honor our past and embrace our future. I think an anonymous quotation sums it up best. The past is the past. They call it that for a reason. Don't let the past get in the way of you or your life. Just keep moving forward to make the future the best you can make it. Thank you.
Thank you, Sarah. It gives me pleasure to introduce our next speaker, who is involved in volleyball, junior classical league, choir, key club, knowledge bowl, and not to mention a curler who competes on the national level. She will be attending NDSU in the fall for chemistry education. I'm honored to welcome my extremely talented classmate, Beth Podall, to the podium.
Distinguished guests, principals, teachers, faculty, family, friends, thank you. Thank you for being here today to help us celebrate our accomplishments. Thank you for your dedication to the senior class and for investing in our last 4 years, for helping us learn and grow and guiding us on the path to graduation. Graduation is a funny time when I think about it. It's both a beginning and an ending. It's a celebration of our past and our futures. It's the best cure for senioritis, but comes with a side effect of never-ending questions pertaining to our chosen paths. Where are you going? What are you doing? How are you going to get there? No matter what next year brings, graduation marks going from top dog to an insignificant newbie yet again. The end of high school is the start of our journey to find our own places in the world. I want us all to look back to our first day of freshman year. I'm sure most of you remember it, although some of us have chosen to forget it. Some walked in, the coolest kids in the group, sporting the Hollister tees and the Abercrombie jeans. Others walked in, ready to learn, ready to tackle those AP classes or make the varsity football team. But everyone had one thing in common. Everyone was terrified of getting lost in the big, big world of Fargo North High School. I remember highlighting my map, color coding it with all my classes, and hiding it in the hall so upperclassmen wouldn't see. I remember hustling from class to class, hoping I could cross the locker bay in 5 short minutes. As seniors, we can now see there's a whole new world out there, a place to explore and to discover. We eventually found our way around North, just like we will each find our places in the world. We were maybe late to a few classes or just used that as an excuse along the way, But compared to the world, North's not that big. It's not that scary. We did learn our way. Now, I want us to look ahead to next year. Many of us are maybe thinking the same things. What if I get lost in college? What if I get lost in life? I read somewhere once that getting lost is the best way to find yourself. To me, being a freshman gives us a new start. To me, we'll be a freshman no matter if we go to college, join the military, or apply to our dream job. After all, the journey doesn't start at the beginning, it begins at the end. Now is the time to discover what the world out there is, what it can give us, and more importantly, what we can give to it in return. So what if we get lost a couple of times on the way? So what if we stumble into history instead of going to math? We'll only open up new doors for ourselves. And 10 years from now, the majority of these mistakes will either be forgotten or will change us for the better. As we leave the security of Fargo North, realize graduation gives us a chance to live, a chance to learn. It may be the end of one chapter in life, but it is the beginning of a brand new one. Stray from the standard script and write your own path. Find your place in the world. Remember the phrase, it's a small world? I kind of hope it's true. Because as we go out on our own, exploring this big, big world, I hope I someday run back into you. You, the people that wrote the first part of my story. You, the members of the class of 2015. We made it. Congratulations.
Thank you, Beth. Over the past few months, Mrs. Robinson, the business education teacher and yearbook advisor at North High, along with students Dominique Alfaro, Gabby Philly, Callie Gibbons, Amanda Ridley, and Sarah Vetter, have collaborated to create the senior slideshow. Please enjoy.
Congratulations, class of 2015. You've made it.
Best wishes, seniors. I'm here to send you out with some good luck.
Congratulations to class of 2015.
Class of 2015! Class of 2K15!
Thank you. debate in student congress.
My favorite teacher is
Snare.
Mr. Snare.
Yes.
Best teacher ever.
Good guy.
I'm gonna miss the simplicity of high school.
I'm gonna miss Emma.
Oh my gosh, okay.
I'm gonna miss seeing all my friends every day.
I'm gonna miss football the most from high school.
My favorite thing about high school was probably doing the labs in AP Bio.
I'll really miss the food.
My favorite part was all of Tessman's life advice and band class.
I guess the biggest thing I'm going to miss about Fargo North is just the cool opportunities that you get here and the cool people that you get to hang out with and spend time with.
I'm going to miss seeing all the shining faces because I'm not going to see any of you people ever again. So I'm going to miss you.
Advertising and Public Relations.
I'm going to NDSU for Animal Science Pre-Vet.
I'm going to Brigham Young University for Computer Science with an emphasis in animation.
I'm going to MSUM for animation.
I'm moving to Colorado and taking the year off. I'm going to be working summer.
I'm going to NDSU.
I'm going to NDSU for a business degree.
NDSCS Welding.
I'm going to UND for really pre-med and athletic training.
I'm going to NDSU for interior design.
I'm going to National Taiwan University for electrical engineering.
I'm going to California Lutheran for business.
University of Minnesota for nursing.
I'm going to NDSU for nursing.
And follow your passion, do what you love, and work hard.
And a piece of advice for you is to know that the world is your playground and enjoy your life.
Don't worry too much about the past, and don't worry too much about the future.
Take care of your shoes, and your shoes will take care of you. Do your homework.
Wear sunscreen.
I'm just the guy that loves North High.
Baby, come back. You can blame it all on me.
Thank you, Mrs. Robinson and students, for collecting and sharing those memories from our senior year. Now, it is my pleasure to introduce Fargo Public Schools Superintendent, Dr. Jeffrey Schatz.
Good afternoon. It's my privilege to be here with you and to celebrate the graduation for the class of 2015. On behalf of the Board of Education, Administration, and staff of the Fargo Public Schools, once again, I do welcome you. To the graduates, congratulations on your graduation and all that you've accomplished along the way. You know, it's really nice to know that after 50 years that Fargo North has been in existence, and as a graduate in 1977 of Fargo North, that you are the number one school in the state and that it's been taken care of so well. So as an alumni, I would say thank you for taking care of Fargo North High School. Everybody, a round of applause for this group. And speaking of alumni, now that you are graduates, you'll become a well-established group, part of that, and that is the alumni of all those that have come before you. Those folks continue to care about the outstanding educational experiences provided for all students who attend North. So I like to do this each year. What I'm going to have is graduates, please stand up. Now I'd like you to turn to the audience. And those out in the audience who have graduated from Fargo North or any other Fargo Public School, please stand up. Let's go, everybody out in the audience. Okay. Graduates, you're going to become part of this group of alumni. Everybody, again, round of applause. Graduates, say thank you. Okay. Today I want to talk to you about the future and what you'll need to know as you engage in the globally connected world that we live in. Graduates, you represent the largest generation and the most diverse group of people in the United States today, the millennials. The millennials range in age from 10 to 35, and as the 2015 graduates, you'll find yourself nestled in the middle of your generation. The one characteristic that sets you aside from previous generations is the sheer amount of technology that has been at your disposal since the day of your birth. The access you've had to information is unprecedented. From information gathering to social connectedness, you're tuned in, plugged in to the world around you. So what does that mean? It means that you hold the key to generations that come after you. Your use of technology to change the current status quo is the legacy which you will be someday measured as millennials. It is incumbent upon you to lead the way in knowledge creation, breakthrough thinking, creativity, and innovation. In his book, 21 Trends for the 21st Century, Gary Marks identifies 20 targets we need to know and be able to do to be prepared for the future. I know you would not be happy if I went through all 20 of those trends, so I will just speak to a few of them. Number one, communication. Reading, writing, speaking, listening, concept development, and research will all play a critical role in your ability to create and innovate concepts considered as new knowledge. Engagement in the language arts provides the foundation to cultivating these communication skills, which are more than ever before a requirement if one is to succeed in the global world. Science, technology, engineering, and math, or what we call STEM today, those related core subjects will provide you the knowledge base to lead discussions for new and innovative knowledge. The arts. The arts cultivate creativity and stimulate out-of-the-box thinking. Imagination, creativity, connects the relationships between innovation and invention. The arts connects the dots and takes us to places never before realized. By engaging in the arts, you will be able to make connections between science, technology, engineering, and math. This collaboration across disciplines is the cornerstone to new breakthrough thinking and knowledge. Social and behavioral sciences, understanding the role of society, identity, diversity, and culture will be a critical skill needed for those who live in a global community. Having good judgment, ethics, and character will be necessary for you to engage in a society with empathy and compassion. Consideration of varying points of view will be essential to a civil society in the pursuit of a common good. Here's the big one. Leadership, management, economics, personal finance, health, well-being, and life skills. What does all that mean? It means you have to have your house in order. You need to take care of yourself in order to be able to do all those other things. Responsibility for one's actions by making sure that you care for your financial and physical well-being will be the key to a happier and more productive life. And finally, another big one, work and life balance. Ensure that your work does not become the mainstay of your life. Finding balance between work and life requires that you care for your family and friends. For in the end, that is all you have. You have leaned on them in times of need, and as you go forth, there will be times again where you may need their support. Conversely, as you walk through life, they will need you. As you transition from the youthful state in which you now exist, you will become the one who will give back and be there when they need you most. Graduates, challenge yourself and dream big. You have every opportunity to be successful in life. Seize the moment and engage in your productively in your future. Congratulations again, and once again, thank you for taking care of Fargo North High School. Good job.
Good afternoon, parents, family, friends, and the graduating class of 2015. My name is Andy Dolan, and it's my pleasure to be serving our school and community as the principal of Fargo North High School. This is my 22nd graduating class at North High School, and it's a job that is very rewarding because of the opportunities to work with outstanding students and an exceptional staff. The stakeholders of our school can be very proud that it's our belief that we have the number one school in the Midwest. I want to thank our community for your continued support. Would our assistant principals and staff please stand? In the fall of 2013, we developed a theme that every student needs a champion, and our staff has endorsed the idea. They have gone the extra mile, and I want to thank our staff for your continued commitment to make North High School number one. On behalf of our students and community, I want to thank you for your efforts in building champions and your contributions to North High School. Let's give our staff a round of applause. Today marks the end of the careers for two North High music teachers, and they represent over 80 years of dedicated service to education. This afternoon, it is my pleasure to recognize the retirees. Would our two retiring employees stand in front on the red carpet and face our graduates? Today, it's my pleasure to recognize our retirees, and I would like to briefly comment on each music teacher. Our first retiree is Dan Italiano. He's the short one. Mr. Italiano had 9 years of teaching experience in Wisconsin, Minnesota, and Indiana schools before accepting the orchestra position at North High. He's been our Spartan Orchestra teacher for the past 30 years, and he's been the Pitt Orchestra director for over 30 musicals. In addition, Mr. Italiano has been the Trowood Orchestra director for 21 shows. His talents have allowed him to rewrite scores of music. He's been a true champion for students because of his dedication and commitment to helping students. You're going to be missed. Our second retiree is Brian Testman. Mr. Testman has been an educator for 41 years. His previous experience includes stops at McCluskey, Harvey, and Ben Franklin Junior High. He's been our concert and jazz band teacher for the past 17 years. In addition, he's been the director for a pep band that was the envy of the conference. I'd have coaches, referees, and even parents from rivals teams compliment the enthusiasm that our students displayed for our school. He's a staff member who loved North High. You're going to be missed. In front of this crowd of over 2,100 attendees, I want to tell our retirees that you'll be missed by your students, your colleagues, and your principal. Today, let's all stand up and give these teachers a standing ovation and a rousing thank you. It's always a pleasure for me on this memorable day to take a few moments to reflect on the class of 2015. This is an outstanding class. They've been ranked number one or two in Class A North Dakota schools on ACT or standardized tests. This senior class has earned over $1.9 million in scholarship money. In addition, our seniors have been state champions in athletics. In fact, just yesterday, our team won the state soccer girls championship. But they've also been state champions in academics and performing arts. There have been gold medalist performances in music, performing arts, and forensics. This is an outstanding class, and I'm very proud of your accomplishments. I wish you the best in your future endeavors. Will the class of 2015 please stand? Platform guests, faculty, parents, family, and friends, it is my pleasure to present the class of 2015, the 50th graduating class from North High School. These students have met all the requirements for graduation as set forth by the Department of Public Instruction and the Fargo Board of Education. It is my privilege to present them to Linda Boyd and Robin Nelson to receive their diploma with all the rights and privileges that go with it. Class of 2015, you may be seated. The first row may be excused to receive their diploma.
The graduates' names will be read in a continuous manner. In order to allow each name to be heard, please applaud only after graduates have all received their diploma. No noisemakers are allowed. Thank you for your cooperation. Sarah Tarvestad. Chance Olson. Ashley Blazik. Beth Podol. Rayissa Abrahamson. Grace Acone. Dominique Alfaro. Amanda Anderson. Jacob Anderson. Lillian Anderson. Tyler Anderson. Alyssa Ani. Christian Barnes. Sarah Barnes. Serafina Bossel. McKinnon Bathy. Samuel Burnson. April Beyer. Michael Bickler. Ryan Bjarke. Garrett Bonham. Madison Bon. Kendra Bonchi. Wyatt Boone. Carly Bosch. Michael Boutain. Jacob Bracken. Austin Breitbach. Kylie Broderson. Peyton Bush. Jamie Cadru. Alec Carlson. Tanner Carlson. Amanda Carpenter. Andra Carter. Adirut Churchusima. Kana Krung. Joseph Clower. Alexander Shomez. Brady Coughlin. Skylar Current. Sydney Cutler Gilbert. Caitlin Dargan. Melanie Dara.
Kurt Deckert. Carl Denton. McKenna Dilbeck. Jacob Doan. Deandra Dravitz. Ty Duncan. Rachel Dura. Ashley Erickson. Andrea Fenno. Gabrielle Philly. Katarina Fisher. Zachary Fossum. Sophia Friesen. Kayla Frosley. Jenna Garcia. Reynaldo Garcia. Callie Gibbons. Tyler Gibson. Samantha Guion. Hudson Giswold. Emma Jesdahl. Garrett Goldotter. Joshua Gonzalez. Autumn Gossett. Sarah Griffin. Jake Hagen. Shad Hagen. Brittany Haynes. Gunnar Hansen. Megan Hansen. Samuel Hansen. Andrew Howe. Grace Harmon. Jacqueline Harmon. Tyler Hartman. Shanda Hayden. Dallas Hayes. Grant Heim. Bailey Heisler. Stacia Henning. Logan Hilber. Hannah Hoag. Nicholas Holler. Allison Hushka. Adam Hovel. Ya Lin Huang. Paula Hewick Lorente. Robert Irie. Lydia Jacobson. Kendra Johnson. Andrew Jones. Chancellor Jorgensen. Logan Kackman. Jill Cattermas. Eli Carlins. Madeline Kenninger. Cameron Kaiser. Grayson Klein. Kristen Cope. Caitlin Kozlowski. Christina Kramer. Alexander Kremlich. Amanda Kreidelkamp. Angeline Kwaku. Alexandra Labor. Emma LaFrambois. Mackenzie Lako. Audrey Lau. Elliot Lau. Caleb Laude. Zachary Laude. Nicole Light. Ava Lapari. Jalissa Magoon. Lindsay Markle. Hayden Martineau. Lucas Mann. Alexander Maxfield. Elias May. Riley McPhail. Caesar Medina. Jay Melendrez. Erica Melick. Nicole Mendoza. Alec Meyer. Preston Milbauer. Nicholas Miller. Clark Melstad. Benjamin Muniz. Benjamin Mostad. Ella Marozola. Alexander Naseth. Bradley Nelson. Scarlett Nelson. Aaron Niehaus. Christian Nillis. Liam Norkett. Stephen Norland. Paige Nygaard. Aaron Nygaard. Palmer Obembe. Emily Odegaard. Chandler Olivson Homan. Alexis Olek. Benjamin Olson. Morgan Olson. Kira Palmer. Fernando Palomo Atienza. Isaac Peterson. Seth Pagel. Brianna Peterson. Deanna Platt. Nathan Potts. Davis Redmond. Abigail Rader. Danielle Reichel. Excuse me, Daniel Reichel. Victoria Reinholz. Cedar Remen. Amber Richard. Connor Richard. Amanda Ridley. Elizabeth Roach. Dylan Robley. Arnold Rodriguez. Lance Runglin. William Roman. Gavin Rook. Carmen Ross. Brandon Rudisell. Christoph Rupert. Elizabeth Russell. Ariana Rusted. Carrie Sand. Cole Sand. Rebecca Sandy. Ian Sander. Caitlin Schaefer. Brandon Schilling. Talon Schlosser. Cole Schmidt. Ashlyn Schrader. Bryce Schroeder. Gina Schwanke. Martha Samenko. Caitlin Skalicki. Cruz Smith. Ellen Solberg. John Stennis. Luke Stevens. Grace Swenson. Maggie Swenson. Justin Tappy. Carter Thompson. Emily Thompson. Jenna Thurston. Christopher Tostenson. Austin Toussaint. Smith Tuya. Andrew Underdahl. William Underdahl. Sarah Vetter. Abraham Volk. Summer Walseth. East Walls. Sarah Wenis. Benjamin Wenzel. Mary Westman. Jaden Williams. Michael Wilson. Megan Wolman. Carly Wright. Wyatt Schuler.
By tradition, the senior members, joined by underclassmen members, give their final performance at graduation. Today, the Fargo North Concert Choir, under the direction of Shelley Zietz, will perform the finale from The Gondoliers, composed by Gilbert and Sullivan.
Danza, cachuca, fandango, bolero, series will drink manzanilla, montero. Wine when it runs in abundance enhances the reckless delight of that wildest of dancers.
And the glitter, 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 clatter.
We'll dance.
Monteris will drink manzanilla, montero, for wine when it runs in abundance. Enhances the reckless delight of that wildest of dances.
That wildest of dances, the reckless delight. Once more, gondolieri, both skillful and wary, free from this quandary, contented are we. Pleasure.
Thank you, Mrs. Zietz. As I mentioned earlier, our class has made memories to last a lifetime. And now, it's time to make one last memory together. How many of you have heard of the new selfie stick invention? I'm sure our class has. We're going to take one last picture together to remember the last time we're all in the same room together. So hold still, and we'll see if we can get this to work and smile big. Okay, guys? I don't know that that works, but that's okay. I'll be posting that on social media. I'll check and see if it worked. Okay. Class of 2015, please stand. Now, please join me in the turning of the tassel. This concludes North High's Class of 2015 commencement ceremony. On behalf of the 2015 graduating class, I would like to thank everyone for joining us on this day of celebration. Good luck, graduates!